edition of Exposed! Exclamation point. My name is Warren Peace, accompanied by the lovely Eileen Toberfell. We'll be your host for this evening. Here in the Exposed Studios, we're on a mission to uncover the truth beneath all the insidious lies we've been fed by the mainstream media for far too long. You might remember last week we uncovered the truth behind Jack Sprout, according to our sources and this photo. Mr. Sprout actually is part of a fraternity initiation stunt in college. Nice try, Mr. Sprout, and FYI, we have our eye on your wife as well. Tonight we have seven truly shocking tales of what really happened to some very famous people. Get ready to have your minds blown with the horrifying details behind stories you thought you knew. We'll give you all the details, and by the end of this episode, they'll all be exposed. First up, the true story of one Rumpelstiltskin.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Germany. The year is 1812, and my name is Rumpelstiltskin. No, you don't have to guess. Rumpelstiltskin. Nobody had to guess my name. That wasn't a thing. That whole story you heard about me spinning straw into gold and stealing a baby and splitting myself in half because I was so mad? Shh, not true. About the only true part of it is I know how to spin straw into gold. But anyone can do that, honestly. You only have to pay attention in home ec. So let's set the record straight. First of all, there was this girl. Let's just call her Beatrix, because her name was Beatrix. And I want everybody to know what a total nightmare she was.
OMG, 1812 is super boring. Everything is totally dusty and smells like a barn. Lame. Dear diary, every day is the same here. I wake up, eat some breakfast strudel, go to school, then go to cheerleading practice where we have like one cheer. I mean, yes, Germany invented gymnastics, but seriously, how many words rhyme with gymnastics? I don't have a boyfriend, so I'm totally gonna die alone, and the humidity is making my hair frizz. How am I gonna get famous with frizzy hair and no boyfriend?
One day, Beatrix, this whole nightmare, decided to take matters into her own hands and start being famous.
Hey everybody, guess what? I met Immanuel Kant, the philosopher who wrote The Inquiry Concerning the Distinctness of Principles in Natural Theology and Morality. That might be a tad specific. Hey everybody, my great-great-great-grandparents were Anthony and Cleopatra. Anyone an Egypt fan? Yeah. And I know how to spin straw into gold. Yeah, that's right. Totally spin straw into gold. See this ring? Bale hit just this morning. So yeah, it would probably be pretty awesome to be friends with someone who can spin straw into gold.
See Beatrix at 5 Cobblestone Lane.
That's me.
Please note, I just told her my name straight up right to her face. I told her my name was Rumpelstiltskin. I saw your unwanted ad.
Excellent. Do you have all the qualifications I listed?
Yes. Oh, one of them. I just been straddling gold.
You're hired.
Not so fast. Before I accept the job, I need to know what the good pay with generous benefits package is.
Well, it's sort of a commission situation.
So I get a percentage of the gold I spend.
Well, how about I give you something even better?
Like what?
Well, I'm sort of just speaking off the top of my head here, but how about my firstborn child?
Your firstborn child?
Sure.
How long am I going to have to wait for that?
Well, I'm not even married yet, but I think that the king of everything has his eye on me, and when we get married, we're totally going to have, like, 20 kids. So I can definitely give you the first one, and I'll barely even miss it.
I don't know.
Oh, come on. Won't you please do this one favor for me? You're so awesome and cool. I bet you can totally spin an entire bale of hay in, like, 5 minutes.
Well...
yarn maker things.
You mean a spinning wheel?
See, totally better at this than I am. Can you please just do this for me? Please? Otherwise, the king will throw me off a cliff into quicksand. Please?
Okay, I'll spin the surrounding gold for you.
Yes!
But at the commission you agreed to, one firstborn child in exchange for straw spun in the gold.
Oh, absolutely. Totally. So, you can just bring your spinning wheel over here and get to it, right?
Sure.
Okay, and see you in the morning. Bye.
So I spent all night spinning the straw into gold, and I have pride in my work. So it wasn't just gold-plated junk, it was 14 karat gold. And I made an assortment. Gold coins, gold bars, gold leaf. I even threw in some gold teeth. Because I knew the king of everything could use a new brew. So the next morning...
Whoa, this is amazing! I can't believe it! All that straw and gold in one night? You really outdid yourself,
Rumpelstiltskin?
You. Wow, this is outstanding.
Full name reveal, number two. Let's keep track.
So, thanks a bunch. Your work has totally exceeded our expectations.
Thank you. Now about the fee.
Of course. Just submit an invoice for the total amount due.
An invoice for a baby?
And the King's Accounting Department will issue payment in full within 100 years. We wish you success in your future endeavors. Bye. The King is going to be so excited. Hey, King, I'm done. I totally just spun straw into gold. All hail me. Is this a pile of gold I see before me? Yes, Your Highness. I spun it from a pile of straw last night.
That is one serious bling pile for show.
Oh, well, you know, just a little talent I have.
You're one beautiful pile of gold. I've fallen head over heels in love with you, pile of gold. I wish that I could marry you, but alas, I cannot marry an inanimate object. So I guess I'll marry... her instead. Pack your things for me, then. You're about to become the queen of everything.
I win! Queen of everything! I'm so stoked. I can't wait to say stuff like, off with his head, and bring me that thing, and off with her head. This is gonna be awesome.
So Beatrix became queen of everything and moved into the castle. And it looked like I was going to collect on my debt of her firstborn child.
Ah, motherhood. What a beautiful experience giving birth to my first child.
I'll take that.
What? Who are you? How did you get in here?
You don't remember me? After all I've done for you?
Oh, wait. Are you the maid? I'm so sorry. Electricity hasn't really been invented yet, so it's sort of dark in here. Fetch me something to drink, maid.
I'm not the maid.
Your voice totally sounds like the maid.
It does not. It does not. Now I helped you, and we had a deal. So hand over that child.
What deal? I don't remember any deal.
You hired me to spin straw into gold, so the king of everything wouldn't throw you into a quicksand shark knitting needle pit. You agreed to pay me the firstborn children.
I don't remember that at all.
Well, that's not my problem.
Give me that baby.
No! Stop it! Now look here. You can chase me all day. You're tall and weird, and I'm faster than you are. How about I pay you $1 jillion? Wouldn't that be nice?
I can spin straw into gold. Why would I need a $1 gajillion?
Can't you let me off just this once? You're so awesome and cool. I'll never promise you my firstborn child again. Promise.
Nope. You owe me a firstborn child. Now hand it over.
Please, whatever your name is, isn't there something you can do to work this out?
You still don't know my name?
Of course I do. It's Sam. Joe. Bill Bob.
You have no idea what my name is.
Look, I have a lot to remember. Which formal crown do I wear for dinners? Which of the royal food tasters is allergic to peanuts? Did I feed the baby yesterday? I don't have time to remember every single person's name whose buns are on gold for me.
Okay, I have a deal for you. And just to make sure you don't try to get out of it, everyone, may I have your attention, please? Gather. The queen of everything and I have a deal to make, and we need witnesses. Okay, the queen promised me her firstborn child as payment for a business arrangement. Naturally, she's not excited about paying off that debt, so I propose the following. If the queen can guess my name, she can keep her child and consider the debt paid. I'll give you 3 guesses. Fair enough?
Oh, sure, yes.
Excellent. All right, everyone, guess number 1.
Your name is Bishop.
That is not my name.
Sure it is, Bishop. You told it to me when we first met.
Untrue. See right here on my chariot license. Absolutely not, Fitzgerald. Guess number 2.
I need a hint.
Okay, it rhymes with crumble milk tin.
Your name is Nicholas.
You're the dumbest person alive. My name is Rumpelstiltskin.
I need another hint.
Rumpelstiltskin. It's Rumpelstiltskin! My name is Rumpelstiltskin.
I'm sorry, I totally have a song going through my head. You know the one that's like... No.
Sorry.
What were you doing again?
You were guessing my name, so I don't take your firstborn child.
Oh, it's Nicholas, right?
Wrong! It's Rumpelstiltskin! I'll take that. I want this child fair and square. They all saw it. Now be gone. This child is mine.
You cheated. King, he totally cheated. Nicholas, totally cheated.
Nicholas.
So that's how it really happened. The queen didn't guess my name. I didn't get so mad, I stamped my foot so hard, it stuck in the ground. Then split myself in half, because I couldn't get free. I took the child and raised her as my own. I named her Nicolette. The queen seemed partial to that name, so it seemed fitting.
Dad, I've been screaming for you forever. I need you to spin me some more gold because Bertha and Birgitta and I are going to Oktoberfest, and I need gold.
Young lady, you know how to spin gold yourself. Just go get some straw, take 5 minutes of your time, and you'll be done.
But I don't have 5 minutes. Can you just do it for me? Please, Daddy, I'd be forever grateful. Please, I can't spin the way you do.
Help.
Well known
10 children. I dare say it was his muse. Let me tell you that.
Hey, naughty naughty. It's great to be here in Westminster. But what's with the uptight chicks in the Abbey? Am I right? How about that traffic on London Bridge this morning? After 2 hours, I wished I was falling down. Is this thing on?
It goes without saying that Charles wasn't a very good stand-up comedian. He claimed it was his passion in life to bring laughter to the slums of England. Rather than crush his dream, I tried to redirect his energy. Now, Charles, you mustn't let the critics hit you down.
It's not the critics, it's this newspaper. Mr. Dickens couldn't coax a chuckle from a barrister, even if he were to bribe him with a bag full of shillings. Why must he be so cruel, newspaper?
Perhaps comedy isn't your calling. Perhaps you could take a stab at being a writer.
Writing. I've always seen myself as an entertainer, a clown for the common folk. But I suppose I could write my jokes as easily as I tell them.
Or a whimsical story. Here, I shall fetch you some paper and a quill. That first day, Charles wrote with fury that near frightened him. And yet, he seemed so happy. Somehow, as though a heavy burden had been lifted from his heart.
Yes, Trevina, I think this will do. This will do nicely. Might I bend your ear a bit, get your opinions on my little jokes?
Oh, Charles, I'd be honored, truly.
Four Pickwickians walk into a pub. No, it needs more setup. A philosopher, a ladies man, a poet, and a bad sportsman walk into a pub. That's too much setup. Comedy, she is a wicked mistress.
You mustn't abuse yourself so.
Perhaps I do need to abuse myself. Perhaps comedy is born of pain and I have not suffered enough. Fetch me a hammer, Georgina.
Charles, I beg of you, this is madness.
Fine. If you won't aid me in my own hour of need, I shall take matters into my own hands. Oh! Yes! I can taste the comedy seeping from my veins.
Charles, please. You have suffered as much as any in England. What with your father thrown into debtor's prison and your work as a child in the factory.
My God, Georgina, that's it. You're a brilliant girl. I'll write my time in the factory.
Charles' faith in himself seemed renewed. He worked late into the night with the fury of 1,000 orphans forced to make lace collars for the royal family. In the morning, when it came to bring him his breakfast tea, he's exhausted, yes, with a spark in his eye.
Not now, please sit. I think I finally struck upon the common chord I see. Lend me your ear.
I'd be delighted.
Oh, I say I get very little respect. Once in the workhouse, I asked for more room, and the overseer said, more, you want more, and tonight we sustenance. I say I get very little respect.
Oh, well, okay.
Then I take out a huge watermelon and smash it! Yes?
Perhaps. Just thinking that the idea of the workhouse might play out best in a short story rather than a joke.
You hate it! I'm a failure! I truly do not get any respect. Perhaps I should just become a cobbler.
No, I don't mean to crush your dreams. It's just that I'd like to find out more about the life of a child laborer. And one anecdote is not enough. Perhaps you can take a stab at writing a novel.
A novel, eh? But that takes so much time. I do still love my connection with the audience and having groupies.
Yes, well, if rather when you are a successful author, you can perform stage readings and book signings.
Yes, I shall begin at once.
It was at this time that I began to realize that Charles was a talentless oaf. But my station in life depended on his success. And my need for chocolates and a desire to stay at the poorhouse. With Charles' energies channeled in a new direction, he seemed happy. He stayed out of the limelight for a while, and I was able to construct my plan for survival. I realized I would need to guide this man.
Thank you.
of clowns, though. The red noses and the oversized shoes. How can they walk without shoes?
Focus, Charles, please.
Just trust me on this one. You're wrong. Exposed. She dreamt of unicorns, rainbows, kitten parties, and giant-sized snow cones.
Sleepy?
Yes.
What are you doing?
I'm narrating.
You're what?
I'm narrating. I cleaned the entire castle, so I thought I'd help out with a little narration.
Wait a minute. You cleaned the entire castle?
Yep.
Even the dungeon?
I gotta go.
No interruptions, no legal stepsisters, and no talking chit-chat advice. Finally, the perfect nap. Nothing.
approximately 37 minutes, at which someone discovered the flask of hand tools were ridiculous. Exposed. Literally. Our next story, we take on big business. Specifically, big candy business. We answer the question, who could take a rainbow, do some stuff to it, make it edible? Due to the nature of this extreme revealing expose, the true identities of our subjects have been changed. Let's just say the CEO of the candy empire has invited a select group of children to tour his factory made of pure sugar. Things have gone horribly awry, resulting in near deaths of all but one of the prisoners. Happily, a young man named Charles, has survived until the very end. We pick up our story as he entered Billy Wonder's office.
Charles,
When you sign this contract, you will become the unquestioned boss of the world-famous Bonkers Candy Factory. You'll be responsible for manufacturing and distribution, as well as the care for the small orange people downstairs who actually make everything happen.
What will you do?
I'll still be around, but I think it's high time I take a vacation. I can provide advice, of course, but the factory will be all yours.
Do it, Charles. I will, Grandpa.
Excellent, fantastic, splendid, adjectives. Let's get in my rocker cab elevator and grab the rest of your family.
Let's share a seat and let the new boss do his thing.
Excellent plan. Wait a minute. What?
You heard me. You were sitting in my seat, Mr. Bonkers.
You're already taking in the new job. I like that. Want to go back down to my strawberry lake and eat some mango-flavored orchids?
No thanks, but thank you. I have plans for that room. Grandpa, pull up a chair and take a memo. Go, girl. You know, Bonkers, I'm not feeling the name Bonkers Candy Factory. I think a new name is needed.
Have you lost your mind? The name of Bonkers is known from Kalamazoo to Timbuktu. My children everywhere look forward to consuming my creations.
Yes, and thanks to your creations, obesity is at an all-time high.
Well, that's not my fault. It's the parents who are responsible. Children today are so spoiled.
Yes, but I plan to change everything in your company. For starters, your Bonkers Cherry Cake Batter and Double Caramel Ice Cream will now become just Bonkers Cherry Yogurt.
Ridiculous. No one will eat it.
I think the name Bonkers Organic Healthy Creations Farm has a nice ring to it, don't you?
Sacrilege! How dare you!
You let him sign it.
Silence, old man! This is an outrage. I hereby declare this contract null and void. My contract! My contract!
Go ahead and tear it up now, Mr. Bonkers. Say hello to the interwebs while you're at it.
That will pull us before it goes too.
Go ahead and ask my
ladder. I think I have you over a barrel, Mr. Bonkers. Don't worry. I'll let you brew my green tea every morning. I take it with honey.
You.
The Bonkers Organic Healthy Creations Farm will help children around the world reach their true nutritious potential through healthy snack offerings.
My candy is nutritious. Look how fit I am.
So, as I was saying, our milkshakes will actually cause children to do jumping jacks. Our drink them will remove plaque and whiten teeth. I believe sodas will contain more vitamins than spinach.
You're mad. I know I should have picked the fact that you got sucked up through the tubes.
His type 2 diabetes is probably irreversible, but that will have him work for me. He can help me convert the chocolate eggs into low-calorie egg whites. And he can also lead the Bonkers Marathon training team.
Charles, before you go completely crazy and send us all to ruin, let's just talk this out first. My whole mission in life has always been to bring a smile to the children's faces, to make the world taste good.
Do we even need Bonkers anymore?
Nah, send him down to the old exploding room. Let me give him a test taster of a keynote of brownie delights for Hollywood movie producers.
Okay, I get it. Candy equals bad, but let me help you. I know how this factory works. I can help you achieve your dreams.
I'm listening.
Okay, I promise to get rid of the high fructose corn syrup and artificial sweetener room.
Good.
But it helped my chocolate bars taste so delicious. Don't you like the flavor?
Not when kids can barely climb the stairs and develop more pimples than there are stars in the sky.
But those candy bars keep those kids from developing bad habits in life. Parents actually depend on me to keep their little girls in mind.
I'm not sure I follow you.
You see, Charles, children need rewards to work for. And what better reward than candy? No one will clean their room or eat their broccoli for the incentive of just a stupid apple.
Apples are not stupid. Besides, my new orchards will produce apples as big as your head. Not only that, they'll give you the ability to do long division problems in your head the minute after you eat them.
Whatever, it's still an apple. They don't comfort anybody. Who's going to sit down on a lonely Saturday night for a good cry, a couple of movies, and a tub of peas and carrots?
Plenty of people. If they know they have to get up the next morning and run 8 miles, we're at Bonkers Nutrition Club set up worldwide.
Can we please give the lazy people some Bonkers sticky stomach taffy just to give them a break from this terrible world?
Sorry, Bonkers. The jig is up.
Grandma.
stepping in. I'm appointing myself CEO of Bonker's Candy Factory to further notice. At first, I went along with your plan, but the products of yours stand alone in ways that are bad and wrong. And a mom may be crunchy. Gross. No! We'll split up the bag. Billy here can continue to make his fantastically magical candy, and you can start with your healthy goodies. As president, I will ensure more people get to experience the Bonker's. Our profits will double.
Listen to your Grandpa Charles. He's a wise man indeed.
I suppose half ownership of Bonkers is better than a lifetime doomed to eating cabbage soup and noodles.
And so, the Bonkers Candy Factory goes on.
I get to keep this corner out.
This is so unfair. Grandpa!
Now go to your room.
Belchy sugar glass.
Don't mind if I do.
Ta-da!
Be there.
Then I took the directions and made a photocopy in the library office, which I have access to since I'm a library student.
You student friends! Let me see the map!
Alright, we went over the river, through the woods, past Goldilocks School for Precocious Girls, and onto the path paved with good intentions. You're right, the party should be right around here. Let's just walk a little further.
Flower snakes.
There are such a thing as flower snakes, Robin.
jolly men. They are merry men. Plus, we don't require your services, Roxy. No little sister of mine is going to be tramping about Sherwood Forest, getting caught up in all manner of crazy adventures.
Crazy adventures? That sounds totally super fun.
It's not fun, I can assure you. It's hard work. Hard. Filthy. Fly by the seat of your pants work. And it's no place for annoying little sisters. And that's fine.
Give me a chance.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Ha! Everyone knows that a no, followed by a question mark, means maybe.
My goodness.
I said no, and I actually mean no.
But I heard a question mark.
Well, your ears are filled with daffodils.
Why are you stretching?
No, no reason. Just staying in shape for the big,
The big what?
The big heist of the sheriff's precious jewels.
I always wanted to take part of a heist.
Well, you cannot. So there. In fact, you wouldn't know what to do if you did join the heist.
Oh, really?
Yes, really. A heist involves a complicated series of perfectly timed movements. Plus, we all made our own costumes. It would be far too. Oh, would you look at the time? I gotta run. Much heisting to do and whatnot.
Sweet guy. Perfect. Why? That's it!
What's it?
Can't explain. Just listen.
Shelter. It is a
just call him Wendy. When he visits Wendy in Never, Nautiland, he tries to avoid a horrible pirate and kept a hook for his hand. You might think you know this story, but I assure you, you don't.
Dog, you need new friends, full rooms.
Now, where is that shadow?
It's around on Ball.
town.
No kidding! In some cities, that's known as stalking! No offense, but we won't be coming back here anymore. I mean, your stories are awesome, and this room rules.
It's called a nursery.
Right, sorry. Like I said, keep the shadow. Time to go take.
Actually, I think we'll be going back with you to your island this time.
What is this?
The name isn't Wendy.
less people know about this other